Yesterday when we chose figure drawing, would not be too much big, usually the small size, as long as you can run your pencil comfortable, that's good. So I prefer to draw the figure, structurally. Although I am very much comfortable with the shape, you don't have to, but for beginners it's really important that, as a method to draw from structure. So this one stands for the rib cage. So sometimes we use the barrel, or sometimes use a box, stand for rib cage. Sometimes we draw a corn, stand for the pelvis. So the point is we need to see that there's two box relation, and also then the head. So you see the spine, the neck, you need to feel the perspective status of the head to do with the rib cage. So first time we start from this, and then we can work on the thigh part. When your thigh part, we need to feel the perspective status of the thigh part, and then the knee part, and then the calf. Yeah, students have usually the easy to notice the shape of the outline, but not so much comfortable, not so much used to draw the inside structure. So sometimes they try to make me happy. They make some little boxes inside of the shape, show me they have some concern about that, but actually not that much easy. They not actually can catch that. So that's always a problem. But that's normal. That's normal. It's not a real thing. So that's why I do the demonstration, to give them some suggestion. See the process I did, probably you will understand more about the process. So yeah, eventually I did do the outline, but when I do outline, I did very carefully about the inside structure. So that helps me to draw a three-dimensional relation. This is the first one. Let's see if some others. straight. So usually we start from gesture line. Even when the model sitting a little straight, you can see a little bit tilted, and you feel that tilted if the neck is here. So usually the middle of the clavicle bone, you can find that it needed to at least goes to one heel. So this is about the balance with the shadow on the picture. So I draw the head. Sometimes the midway is the pelvis. The midway is the pelvis. So like I said, sometimes we use a coin stand for the pelvis. This kind of pelvis includes the whole hip. It's not just inside the pelvis. Draw the leg, you need to consider. Yeah. This pose looks a little bit looked down, so you can see there's a shape. Shape. Curve. So. For rib cage. Okay. So next here. Rib cage. First. The shoulder. Your head more light. Head. Yeah, I want to show you the three dimensionally. Okay. So you see that relation, not just a outline. Even when you draw this line, you need to feel it's you're looking up towards the box. So this shape looks like this. So you may draw the hairs, but it's important you see the head like this. And kind of cool. You can see the muscle. So it's a cladal, sternal cladal mastoid. So, of course, it's a detail. So the rest. draw detail a little bit, the detail of the hand. It's okay. It's very important to, if you draw detail of the hand, it will catch the shape of the thigh part and the wrist. It helps you to catch the shape of it. And this one, the same thing. Catch the thigh part first, and then the rest of the fingers. Yeah, when we do the sketch, we don't have to erase. Even something was wrong, just leave it there. Yeah. Just leave it there. And sometimes we can restate the line. We feel I did not so accurate, we can restate it. You don't have to outline everything. So like this leg, I could just leave it like this. The sketch is enough. Yeah. This is the second one. Let me find the camera. Come over a little bit this side. So I work on the third one. This is also a front one, so this is opposite curve line. It's more this way. Yeah. Like this. So sometimes we can catch the shoulder like this, the pelvis like this. Usually it's always have an angle, and then we can find the line of here, the line of the thigh part. It's very easy to find. And you can find another line, usually more extended as well. It's for the body. And then the neck. Sometimes there's no standard process to draw. When you do the sketch, when you feel something for sure and interested to draw, you can just draw. You don't have to worry, I haven't do this yet, why I do this so much. And sometimes when we draw a sketch, especially when we have the life model, it's better to base on the feeling to draw. Yeah, but I still feel it's important to find the structure instead of just outline. But of course, when you're very good at the structure. Very good at the structure, and you can
work
directly. Like my habit is more usually directly draw the outline. But it's not double standard, it really depends on how much you can do. Depends on your So I'm doing the outline like this and this, but actually I'm looking inside. I'm looking inside and feel the inside stretch. It's very important. And the ankle, let's see, it's higher, it's lower. And then, yeah, actually I'm structurally understanding the object. That's why you see the line feel more accurate. Yeah, so yeah, so this is for second one, but the difference is this one I did not do too much the rib cage and started to outline more earlier. Yeah. Let me find maybe a last one. Maybe a more side one or more dynamic. Dynamic pose. I moved the camera to more right. Lights more right. Okay. So this one is a little more perspective feeling because the rib cage is more like a looking down situation. So the rib cage, you need to understand that the rib cage could look like this when you look down. So you need to understand when you draw the head or draw the neck, you need to feel like it's a plant onto the rib cage. And then when we draw the head, we need to understand it could be more, you see the shape of this is the head, and neck, and the rib cage. Yeah, and you feel this kind of the depths of the body, and then draw the arm. Oh, yeah. And then you see the folds between the rib cage and the pelvis. And here the pelvis also has a problem, like it's very foreshortened. And actually it's overlapping under the rib cage. In most of situations, students easy to draw like this situation, like the top and the bottom, you know, this relation up and down. But this one's more overlapping. So although there is a distance between the pelvis and the rib cage, but in this perspective situation, they're overlapping. Yeah. So this is something difficult to understand. And the thigh part, the knee. Yeah, you see the knee part looks so long compared with the torso because of the perspective. And then the cave. Yeah, cave. And foot, and another leg, in the feel the leg, yeah, and then cave. So yeah, I need to feel like it's going down into a little more further backwards.
Okay, now I'm selecting some figures, male figures to draw.
Draw from 1, 2, 3, 4. So first one, I draw the extra line. This body is very much, it's not so clean. My drawing board has a fold. So you need it. Yeah, usually at the very beginning, most important thing is you need to see what's the perspective status of the rib cage. If you can look at the bottom or you can look at the top. So of course it's not so much simple, the real rib cage, but then we more simplifies it. It's good for understanding of the perspective. So the pelvis. So sometimes the pelvis, it's not actually aligned together. So you can see the banded, it's an angle. Draw the thigh part. Side part. And the knee part. And calf. And the ankle. And the foot. Toe. So this is the way to draw. So another thigh part. Sometimes it's good to catch the profile. It's good to see that three-dimensional feeling. So yeah, it's not really existing on the photo, but it's based on your understanding. So calf. And also so there's two legs you can join the muscle to connect the rib cage and the pelvis, and so can be also connecting the shoulder and the rib cage. So we have the neck plant onto the chest. Sometimes when we feel the warmth is comfortable, usually because we can see the logic, spatial logic of the work. So the muscle. Okay, then we draw the elbow. But this photo a little bit. It's actually to this side because the lens is not close by this side. So this arm looks a little bigger, so a little smaller. Shoulder, but this one is very foreshortened, but sometimes you need to tell that upper arm and the forearm is different form. They plug together. So now we work on finger. So this is the way. Sometimes we can adjust a little bit, since when we look at this inside the structure, not necessarily it's so accurate. Therefore, sketch not necessarily that accurate. So okay. I have the model this way, okay. Leg. Yeah, sometimes when we do sketch, we could just grab something differently for the detail. Doesn't matter, you don't have to follow with a certain consequence. The very drawer, as long as you're confident about the shape, you can start to work on it. So it depends on your pose or your motion. If you can just work on that part. Myself, usually I just started to draw from a certain part, not go around everything. It depends. Some people feel like more comfortable with work, with working, start from more general process. Inside structure, a bit more directly to draw what I can see. And yeah, sometimes the beginning line could be long, but it doesn't matter. I guess sometimes it would a little bit take adventure, it's not a big issue. much more comfortable with this process. But this one, more analyze the structure, is also good. Do a third one. Difficult to draw. Yeah. So, the rib cage is here. The neck. Rib cage.
Okay,
work on the shoulder, so we can work on the deltoid and joint was too low, so I move it up a little bit. Like this is okay. If you're not too much required to do details. So this is okay. So I will do the last one, try to find a pose for the last one. So this one is the rib cage. Look at this way. Side, the cage is more back and side, so twist it. This way. Shoulder. Another shoulder. And then the facial part. Right, so move the camera to front.
So this is a demonstration for different poses, like each one like 5 minutes.